That video was amazing, and I don't mean like that it was beautiful or whatever, even though it was. It looks like a lovely little walk around an area. It's amazing because it's entirely artificial. That did not actually happen. It wasn't even made via CGI with like a team working to create that scene. That was just an AI generated video. A few lines of text produced all of that. And we've got a lot more, and they're wild. They're all incredibly impressive and span diverse subjects. We're gonna show you those. But first, you just have to acknowledge that the system is shockingly capable, and it is made by the same company that has produced ChatGPT, that has obviously produced a lot of conversation about AI. This new system they call Sora, after the Japanese word for sky. The team chose it because it evokes, quote, the idea of limitless creative potential. What also evokes the idea of limitless creative potential is creatives being able to be employed to use their talents, but probably not for long, because systems like this are becoming capable at a rate that I don't think anyone expected. Now, obviously, they produced this system after training it. You can see another one of the entirely artificially generated images next to us. That was literally just a couple sentences. It was actually me. Couple sentences produced that, and you'll see more. They are declining to say how many videos the system learned from or where they came from, although they did say that the training included both publicly available videos and videos that were licensed from copyright holders. So they are implying that they have not violated any copyrights in the creation of it, which many generative AI systems did initially to produce their text-based ones. And that system is not publicly available right now. There's a group of testers that are trying to test it for weaknesses and exploits, and obviously there are a lot of concerns about what could be done with a system like that. Maybe you'll come up with more as we show more of that video. But Francesca, I want to start with you. What do you think about what AI can accomplish already?
Meh. I mean, I don't know. I give that a C+ on the whole CG scale. Like, that wasn't, I didn't really do it for me.
We might have millions of people watching this show, but you can be the difference maker, because we just need 1% of our audience to be paid members. And then this show can be around forever. So you can make that difference. Click join now.
Here's the real thing about so-called innovation. All of it is rolled out to ostensibly make our lives easier, and apparently it requires less work and it's a greener technology. BS, BS, BS. It's always been BS when it comes to what Silicon Valley has wrought on workers of this country. And now we're talking about CG graphics artists, right? Graphics artists who, oh, lo and behold, are unionizing as we speak, have formed unions, whether it's working at Marvel or other entities, right? And all of this is generated on the backs of the work that they've already done, number one. So it's already generated on human work. And then number two, there are no protections for those workers to ensure that their work is protected and that their companies will continue to hire them, rather than sort of compete with an open AI new software, this Soro software. Like, that's wild to me. And then finally, all of it is wildly water intensive. So in order to cool down the data processing centers that create AI images and videos like the ones you see, it requires fresh water. That's right. So all of this, it's like crypto. Oh, mining crypto, it's super green. No, 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 no. No, it's not, because all that stuff has to be cooled, all the data has to be cooled down on something that like a very talented graphics artist could have done if you paid them right. It is a war on working people, even if you think it looks cool.
Okay, so you kind of like it, kind of don't. Okay, Trae, what about you?
I mean, you know, Francesca said meh. So I saw all this last night, all these clips, and I saw it on a Reddit thing. I was reading the comments on it and watching the videos, and I don't know, maybe my gummy was just kicking in the wrong way at the wrong time or something, but it really freaked me out. And it was the first time that that had happened with me and AI. The last time the three of us were on the power panel together, we talked about that George Carlin AI comedy special.
Yeah.
And I was, and me and Francesca were both at that kind of like, but you know, it wasn't actually funny. I still don't think they can't achieve the same. You got to be in the room with the comic. It's a shared experience that, it's, I don't know if it's ever going to be able to replicate that. I was kind of downplaying it. And obviously, these videos aren't specific to like comedy, but just reading some of the people, you know, like prognosticating where this type of thing could go in the future. And it's like, you know, you feed an AI a book series, the text of a book series, like the Game of Thrones series or something, and it just produces a whole new different.
A better ending.
Better ending. Yeah, exactly. Right. You know, whatever it's like. And, you know, they're saying they're nowhere close to that right now. But what we've just been watching a couple years ago, people were like, oh, that's way far away. Right. And now it's here. So, like, I don't know. Yeah. It is kind of freaking me out. Also, I will say, as somebody who has tried and failed numerous times to get a sitcom on the air, have many failed pilots, the idea of being able to write a script and then have something actually come from that, even if it's computer generated, like, selfishly plays for me. But at the same time, that's the wider implications are bad, because it's just going to crush the entire entertainment industry. I saw people speculating that it might be more like social media in the future, kind of like anybody can sort of generate their own TV series or movie from whatever they put into it. And then you get popular and get followers based on that. And that's how it works. But what's the, you know, how does any of that work in terms of an industry or career or any of that? So I don't know. It freaked me out, y'all. I'm freaked out about it now. So that's where I'm at.
I share the freaked out. I think you're totally right. Yeah. It's going to create new, like, people are going to use this in a creative fashion. But a lot of people will lose their jobs, and a lot of people's prior work is the only reason that this can exist in the first place. You're totally right about that. I have some other concerns. We'll get to that in just a sec. But first, Trae, you mentioned, you know, how far it's come in just a short period of time, and I want to demonstrate that to people. Can you, for a second, can you just give me a few seconds of the dogs in the snow, just for context, that this is what Sora can make now, these dogs in snow. I mean, that is not, that's wild and also among the most adorable things I've ever seen in my life. Okay, so that's what Sora can make now. I'm gonna show you a video that was posted last year that represents about the best that AI could do in taking a few lines of text and producing a video. I'm not joking, this is about the best they could do less than 1 year ago. Wow, I didn't realize the sound was still gonna be in that. That is, if you couldn't guess, The Rock eating rocks. And that is the best it could do. And now it's like photorealistic golden retrievers playing in the snow. And those videos are so good that, like, it's hard to notice the flaws in a lot of these, even if you know it's AI. If you're like, if your dad didn't know that was AI, there's no way he would suspect that it was. And right now, they're making golden retrievers. But what could they make Ilhan Omar say? You know?
Yeah.
What could they make AOC say? What could they do with a video of Barack Obama? Like, we should be concerned about this being used not by OpenAI. They're gonna have protections or whatever for, like, revenge porn, but also disinformation. There are a lot of reasons to be worried about this. And this is less than 1 year progress from the rock eating rocks to the videos you saw. Where is it gonna be in a couple of years?
I mean, the Biden campaign is like, oh, please, 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 I hope it's there, because we need artificial intelligence. Joe Biden, let's go, baby.
A video of him with his face in the snow.
A video, yeah, exactly. No, but seriously, they can't wait, because they will absolutely deploy AI Joe, because that will be way better than whatever they have right now. Once again, the CPUs are like massively consumptive. Just to do what? Have puppies in snow? Get a puppy. Go put a puppy in snow right now.
I will. Trae.
Yeah. No, I mean, the you know, all that type, the revenge porn, disinformation, all that, you know, you say what you want about the implications for the entertainment industry. And obviously, I feel strongly that that should be regulated too. But those aspects of it, like, they need to be working on that in DC, like, right now. You know what I mean? Like, that needs to be codified, outlaw, you know, and outlined in legislation, like, sooner than later, because of how fast this is moving. But I had been sort of shrugging it off mostly, up until like literally last night when I, and now I'm, it's like, it's been a paradigm shift for me personally.
The wolves are at the gate.
Yeah, they are. I mean, it's pretty wild.
The barbarians. I forgot who's at the gate. Someone's at the gate. I'm not sure.
I think it's both barbarians with wolves. Yeah. But I think that my only hope, and I said this last time about the, is that when it gets there and they Netflix or whoever starts putting out fully AI produced series and stuff, which we all know that they will. My only hope is that when that happens, there's some kind of at least uncanny valley effect to it where it's just not the same for people. Do you know what I mean? Like it's just not as good. It can replicate it, but it will never be quite the same. And people will be able to discern that even if subconsciously, and therefore they won't. Or if failing that, maybe we'll all be like the equivalent of vinyl records in a few years, and hipsters will still like us. And that'll be enough to.
I love how low your bar is. I'm like, let's get a universal basic income before displace us. You're like, just something so we can know.
Yeah.
So when we're flooded in climate change, icy waters, we'll know that we're the real people and they're fake.
Hope so. I'm very concerned. You can put a watermark on it, but I agree. Like I hope that there's still some place for like artisanal, locally sourced, free range human creativity. So hopefully Z and Gen Alpha will like that stuff, because otherwise there's an iceberg ahead. I don't think most people see it.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.